Well, it was in 97. First time in Japan, we played in Arch Enemy. With Arch Enemy in Japan, I mean. Our record label had set up a meeting to meet with Caparison. So they kind of found me. So they just showed up at the hotel and had a few guitars. It was two TAT, you know, that old model. Right, and one was orange, kind of orangey, and one was blue. And the orange one had two humbuckers. And the blue one had two single coils and a humbucker. But I remember wanting the pickup configuration of the orange one, but the color of the blue one. But I couldn't, that's how I had to choose, because I couldn't have both. So I chose the blue one. So I played that for a few years. Well, I do consume a lot of different kinds of music, so that's really hard to say. There's all kinds of styles. I'm always looking for new stuff. But I don't know, I mean, I used to be a real geek, you know. I just played video games, video game music, I guess. And then my mom would play classical music. She would make me listen to, you know, all the classics. And there was so much to discover, all the 70s, all the metal. I started with metal, you know, like all the big metal bands, Slayer, Metallica, and all that, Megadeth. And then I kind of went back through the years to the older stuff. I'm writing a new album, solo album. It's going to be coming out next year. And I'm looking forward to doing that. I've been starting to track it, and I'm going to keep doing it. We're touring now, so I'm going to keep doing it. So that's going to be cool. It's a bit more guitar-oriented. The last one was more stripped down. New one's got a bit more lead playing and stuff, so it should be exciting. I switched from Seymour Duncan pickups to DiMarzio pickups. I wanted a single coil. So I've got a five-way toggle switch, so I can do sort of, if I've got this, the second position there, I get these two pickups. Classic Ibanez. Kind of. So I can get loads of cool sounds there, but I usually play just these two though, with Arch Enemy. Except in the studio, I might use a single coil for clean parts. So yeah, it's got a very soft finish here, not a lot of gloss and signature there. And the paint is, I asked Itaru to make it a bit, you know, like an old SG sometimes turns a bit green, an old white SG. So I wanted that kind of tint. So it's a tiny bit of green in there, you can tell in some light. Yeah, and I decided to take the tone knob away because I played. Well, I played a show once with the tone on full. We had a guitar tech. He always used to just twist all the knobs down to make sure there was absolutely no sound while he was doing changing strings or whatever. I remember playing the whole show with that, and I had this amp I wasn't familiar with. And I was like, oh, there's no, I can't get any treble. I was turning the treble presence up, you know. And then finally, we were doing this, like, ending, and I was just going like that, and okay, that wasn't it. But anyway, I don't use the tone, sometimes in the studio, but never live. I just want to keep it simple. Yeah. the inlays are pretty cool. It's I didn't have any ideas for inlays, so Itaru came up with these. He took it from an old banjo or something. It's pretty cool because they're all different. You know, they keep changing, so it's pretty trippy. Yeah. Art Deco. I guess it is, yeah. They're a high-end guitar, you know. They're up there with Paul Reed Smith and those kinds of brands, you know. And I think people who want really high-end musical instruments should check them out.